Last month, we launched Neo, who's our newest platform engineer. And I understand that this month, we're talking about teaching Neo some new skills around policy.
So yeah, today we're introducing Pulumi Policy in the Cloud, which extends the Pulumi platform to provide conformance and best practices posture reporting for all of your infrastructure. This new cloud capability makes it simple for all Pulumi Cloud users to find and manage all infrastructure policy issues. Mm-hmm. And then enable your developers to burn down those policy issues that are found in a way that's an integral part of your developer experience. We also are providing out-of-the-box policy packs for many of the standard conformance specifications, whether that's HITRUST or PCI or NIST, allowing you to easily add them to your posture report and gain visibility into how your infrastructure is doing relative to those. So this policy experience is built also on top of the policy as code infrastructure that Pulumi has had for several years now. It also allows you to build out your own best practices packs that, when combined into this overall experience, enables you to ensure that your organization and your infrastructure is delivering on the requirements of your organization.
It's always a really good idea to have a good handle on your security infrastructure and kind of know where you're standing and where your posture is in your cloud. But one thing I found is that when you do scans kind of retroactively against existing cloud resources, it has this tendency to generate an absolutely massive backlog. And one of the things that I was curious about is with Neo, with this agentic portion of it, and the new policy packs and capabilities, is there anything there that basically helps to handle that unexpected backlog of items on existing engineering teams?
With this launch, we are announcing that we're extending Neo with new skill, with the context tools necessary for Neo to help you with the overall policy governance. And this allows you to leverage AI to work through that mountain of policy issues that you're referring to and drive to get your organization clean from the perspective of policy governance.
That's really exciting. Let's go chat with Luke so he can show us exactly how this works with Neo.
Sounds great.
Hey, Luke.
How's it going, Zach?
Good, good. So I understand you're using our new Pulumi policy experience to kind of improve the best practices of our cloud footprint.
And I am. And to get started in doing that, I first used Pulumi's cloud resource scan to get a little bit more information about our AWS environment and the resources we have running there. So after that, I then did a quick audit scan using our brand new Pulumi HITRUST policy pack to get a little bit more information and dig down into those policy issues. Here on the main policy findings dashboard, I can go and group by AWS regions, giving me a top-down view of our entire cloud footprint. We have a bit of a compliance gap. Right now, only about 50% of our resources are compliant. So let's dig into our policy issues. Let's show that in action. Here on the main policy findings dashboard, I can go and group by AWS regions, giving me a top-down view of our entire cloud footprint. We have quite a bit of a compliance gap. Right now, only about half of our resources are compliant, and we have over 2,000 different policy issues to address. That's kind of a lot to tackle at once, so we're going to drill down into one critical region here.
Which one?
I think we're going to focus in on Canada West 1. I have a few issues here, so we have a few P1 issues that I'm going to select. And then we're going to go click remediate and pass that off to Neo. First, Neo will investigate all the selected issues. Since these are all resources not yet managed by Pulumi infrastructure as code, its next step is importing them into a Pulumi stack. After that, Neo will generate the code to fix all the issues we selected. Here, we can see that Neo has created a new plan based on those instructions. Neo will then go and import those resources and propose a few different code changes. It will then go validate its own changes using Pulumi preview and present a before and after summary. Let's wait for Neo to wrap up its work. Let's check out this pull request that Neo created. In the summary here, you can see that Neo has remediated all the issues that we have selected. I'm going to go quickly check the code that was generated to make sure it looks good. Okay, awesome. This looks good, so I'm going to go ahead and approve this PR and merge it in. Okay, good. So the cool part about this, Zach, is once the PR is merged, our deployment pipeline will automatically push these fixes to the cloud.
Awesome.
Cool. So back in the issues dashboard, we can see that all the violations we targeted are fixed in just a few minutes, allowing us to take a critical region from a state of non-compliance to clean.
Man, that is really powerful. But you know what? You've actually given me another question for Craig. I'm going to go talk to him about this. Luke showed me how Neo can help remediate policy findings en masse. And I think that's fantastic with the speed of what AI can do for us today. But it does kind of echo some concerns of a lot of leaders in this space, where AI is accelerating absolutely everything. But how can we be sure that we're operating and doing those things safely? How are we controlling, I guess, for the risk of what AI-generated infrastructure might do to certain like production systems?
Since Neo is an integral part of that overall Pulumi platform, then it means that all the infrastructure changes it makes are also gated by the Pulumi policy controls, and you know that you have provision for your overall infrastructure. Mm-hmm. So not only does this policy governance give you the visibility into the posture of your infrastructure related to whatever controls you have assigned to it, it also provides the trust model needed to ensure that AI and all of your engineers are delivering within the bounds of the organization requirements and making it safe for you to move at the speed of AI.
I'm going to go chat with Luke and see if we can get a demo of exactly how that works out. Hey, Luke. I was just talking with Craig, and he was talking about how we have out-of-the-box policies with this new experience and also some custom policy packs.
Right.
So I was just curious if you could actually kind of step me through how that custom policy approach looks.
Yeah. Let's take my organization, for example. We already have all of our administrative access configured the way that we want for things like our deployment pipelines and other resources. So what if we want to prevent creating new overly permissive IAM roles going into the future?
Okay.
Let's see if we can ask Neo to tackle that for us.
Yeah, sounds good. Let's see it.
All right. I'm going to ask Neo to create this new policy pack for us. Okay, awesome. Neo's just written the new Pulumi policy code to enforce our new rule. Let's go ahead and approve these changes. After merging and publishing the pack, we can go ahead and enable it on our default preventative group here. So we scroll on down, we open up our configuration, and we can enable it right here. Click done, and save the policy group.
Okay, and that applies to all groups?
Yeah, all of our stacks.
So now that you've published this custom policy, what does it look like when an engineer or Neo tries to write some code that goes against it?
Yeah, sure. Let's actually test it with the stack that I have that has a read-only role that is currently passing all of our policy checks.
All right, let's check it out.
Let's use Neo to edit this role and attempt to give it a little bit more access.
Okay.
Here, you can see that Neo has modified the code, but watch what happens when it runs the preview.
Hey, it actually looks like the preview failed.
Yeah, so as you can see here, our new mandatory policy caught the issue before it could ever be deployed. It clearly tells us which policy violated it as well.
Oh, okay. So that's actually a great experience.
Yeah, yeah. So the cool part about this, Zach, is this isn't just a rule for Neo. If I tried to write the same code on my laptop in VS Code and ran Pulumi up, I'd actually be blocked by the same exact policy. This kind of sets policy up to be a good guardrail for both AI assistants and human engineers alike, giving us, you know, the ability to not only start our infrastructure clean, but most importantly, to keep it clean throughout the development process.
Yeah, that's great. So it kind of points out to like your good platform engineering practices where you want to be sure that nobody can really harm right. the way the production fits. So those policy rails, they're there regardless of it being an engineer, being an AI. That's amazing to see in action. Thank you so much for showing this to me.
Yeah, exactly. No problem.
I think that's really cool to see AI bounce off of custom policies like that. I find even when I'm using code locally and I'm using agentic modes, that always flows a little bit better when there's some unit tests or security scans for it to kind of bounce off of feedback and loop and iterate on its own.
Right.
So it's kind of the same thing I'm seeing here, but it's against like infrastructure, which is really, really exciting stuff.
Yeah, that's the advantage of taking the application development sort of programming model and CI/CD and applying that to infrastructure. It allows us to sort of ride the coattails of what's being done, of how LLMs and AI is extending going forward and how it's iterating in this way you're talking about, that bouncing off of issues it's finding and kind of fixing itself as it goes along. So the same thing can happen here in this world of infrastructure development with AI.
Yeah, yeah. How do you see the future going for like the future roles of software engineers, cloud engineers, security engineers? How do you see that all kind of changing with this landscape?
Yeah, it's interesting. You know, things are changing just so fast across the industry. But today, with security and security teams and engineering, infrastructure engineering teams, there's quite the gap in the process and the workflow. You know, the security teams are running security specific tools that are finding policy issues, conformance issues, those sorts of things. And the way they do this is they sort of build out the specification of what's required for their organization through conformance or best practices. And they write these long specs, or they leverage industry specs around high trust, those sorts of things, which can be hundreds of pages long. And they build these out and then they hand them off to the infrastructure engineering teams to implement the policies that are defined in them. And that process of handing off, defining it and then handing it off, produces more work for the engineering teams to figure out how are they going to enforce these controls. And that work gets scheduled and has to be planned for, those sort of. So it can be months between introducing infrastructure and introducing these policy specifications and actually have them be implemented in the, and be controls within the engineering team. And that gap can get frustrating. And that whole process is also dynamic.
Right.
It changes over time as your best practices or conformance requirements change. And so the struggle of the security teams getting their needs delivered by the engineering team, when the engineering team has other requirements, that gap is pretty significant.
So do you see maybe something like the ability to write some policies in natural language that might actually be able to like speed that up? Or you could see like maybe a little bit more magical sauce to this, so kind of builds on the demo that Luke gave earlier. You see maybe just maybe even business users or security teams, they can just write in natural language creating these policies themselves?
Yeah, that's exactly right. I mean, how do you close the gap there, right? So that gap that we talk about, and how do we eliminate that gap or dramatically shrink it? Well, one of the ways is if you can and get the security teams, instead of writing these formal specifications, can they actually write the controls in a way that directly apply to the engineering's team's workflow and their existing systems? So if you can enable AI natural language-based policy controls to be written by, as you said, business people or security folks, and have them go through a normal approval process, engineering approval process, to bring them in to the engineering CI/CD pipeline, then you close that gap to allow security requirements to be real time and directly affected the engineering experience. You know, engineers love always making sure that they're doing the right thing. And so taking that in, but doing it in a way that is just natural to their overall experience. And so if you can combine those two, then you really are fundamentally changing how the experience works between those organizations.
Yeah, that sounds great. It shifts left the whole thing. And as an engineer, I can say I've been as frustrated as I am by the occasional like pipeline failure, it's a much more empathetic process than finding out months later that something was terribly wrong.
Yeah, there's nothing worse than going back to stuff you've done many months ago and having to figure out what you know, what the issues are and how to remediate those. So
yeah, right. Okay. Well, thanks so much for chatting with me. I understand that Pulumi Policy is launched today. The general experience is available for all commercial users of Pulumi Cloud.
Yeah, that's correct. We wanted to make it simple and available to as many users as we could that are, you know, users of the Pulumi Cloud commercial experience. So,
all right. I look forward to seeing all the feedback come in from people that get out there and go give this stuff a try.